Generally on the railroad, we have 5 to 6 crews. They're not all shooting at once because we basically have to cover 24 hours a day. There are also a bunch of stationary and remote cams that can just sort of get establishing shots. We don't use them a lot. Sometimes we use them just to sort of bring you into something that's going on, and you actually see the cameras in the shots, and you sort of get, it helps you with the architecture of the space and where things are. But we can use them if for some reason the cameraman or camera person isn't there, we can at least start recording with those.
Okay, and what are some of the rules in the house?
The big rules are the idea of this show is that these roommates are coming to live together to experience each other. So we don't have a TV in the house. We used to have a TV the first 4 or 5 seasons, but what we found out is that people, like, rather than deal with each other, they'll just watch a TV. So no TV. It's always been about 7 people who normally would not live together. Because that, by having people who normally wouldn't live together, you're gonna get people who challenge each other. You know, they come from different worlds, they have different experiences. And you're out of that challenging, you're gonna get, and out of that conflict, you're gonna get growth. And that growth has always been, for us, the story engine. So starting with last season, we felt we needed to do something to sort of amp it up a little in today's reality world. And so last season, 4 weeks in, their exes all moved in. Unbeknownst to them, they had no idea. We pulled it off, it was incredible. And they were forced to sort of deal with their exes, because often your ex is the first person you had sex with. They're the first, you may judge future relationships by them, and they're still there's a possessive relationship, especially when it was that first love. And because a couple relationships had already started in the house, it was pretty interesting television. It's more than just a show to me. You know, in a way, it's my sort of liberal manifesto that we need to expose ourselves to people different from us, that we need to, as individuals, we need to go beyond our own little worlds. And through our inclusion of gays, lesbians, transgendered people, and all just kinds of diversity, I think the show has had a really positive effect on the young people who watch it. So I love this show, and I'd love to keep making it as long as people will watch it. You know, I think, you know, the great thing about television is it's a democratic process, and it will be very clear to me when it's outlived its usefulness.